Moi! Today we have filming day here at Countryside Place, and Lauri is there, and something really weird is going on, but you can watch that video later on Beyond the Press channel. And today I want to tell you a bit more about the place where I have grown up. And this place is my mummula, and mummula means place where grandma lives, because grandma is mummu in Finnish and mummula is place where grandma lives. So this is mummula. And my home is about 300 meters to this way, and it's really beautiful and lovely place, and my parents still live there. But today I tell you a bit more about my mummula place, because this farm has really interesting history.
Nelly! Kss, 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 kss. Hello!
The farm has really long history, and I don't even know all things, but I try to explain things shortly and clearly. So let's go! If I want to tell you about this farm, I have to first tell about Hatanpää Manor, which was real mighty manor about 200-300 years ago. And that manor owned almost 40 farms around the province, and this farm was one of them. A householder of the farm lived here. There was huge main building, but it has been demolished about 100 years ago. And the yellow house was for the workers, and nowadays it's bigger and it's the main building. Even this farm was part of manor. This was pretty big farm because they had even workers. And householder or workers weren't my relatives, because they came later. In 1912, the family who owned the manor of Hatanpää, they did some kind of economic crimes, and whole manor thing went bankrupt, and they lost all lands and farms. I filmed this video last week, but now my dad told more information what happened after the manor's bankrupt. So when the owner of the manor lost all his farms and lands, rich family called Rosenlew bought the farm, and they owned it almost 30 years. And then the Winter War started 1939. And Finland lost Karelia, part of Finland, to Russia. Of course, people from Karelia needed a place to go and live, and many wealthy farmers and families sold part of their lands to government, which sold their lands to people from Karelia. It was really huge project to find new homes to all Karelian people. Over 400,000 people escaped from Karelia to other parts of Finland. So Rosenlew's family sold the farm to government that some Karelian family would get the home. So here starts the story of my family. So my grandpa's family, he was my dad's dad,
They lived in Karelia and they escaped from Karelia during winter war, but they went back during armistice because Karelia was their home. But then continuation war started and they had to leave their home permanently. My grandpa was born in 1938, so he was just small kid when all this happened. And after the wars, first they moved to Tampere, the town where we live now. And actually, they live just about 2 kilometers from here. And that feels really nice. In 1949, so 70 years ago, my family and another Karelian family, they bought the farm. There had been a few Karelian families before them, but the farm had been too big and expensive for them. But my family and another family managed to keep it together. But about 10 or 15 years later, the another family moved away and my family stayed. And now back to the farm.
So my grandpa's dad, Emil, farmed the lands, and then they had animals, and later my grandpa and his brother continued to his work.
So that was history part, and we are ready with Beyond the Press video, so Lauri can help me with this video, so Lauri is filming guy. Woohoo! So now I can do like farm tour. So as I said, this is main building nowadays, and my grandma, mummu, lives there, and my grandpa, pappa, died 10 years ago. And that's like cow house, or what is navetta?
I have no idea.
Okay, yeah, but I still remember when there were animals. That was about 20 years ago. There were cows and pigs, and then there is like machine hall. We call it konehalli, which is machine hall.
And there is also small workshop on that end.
Yeah. And I have spent really much time here because my home is really close, and this is really small village. So all my schoolmates lived far away, at least 5 kilometers away. But my second cousins lived really close, and we have played here together really much. Then there are some old barns, and one barn collapsed last winter and we burned it. And you have seen video about that. And then I show you the best part. We have still 2 tractors here. Even my family doesn't farm lands anymore. One local farmer has rented all fields and lands. And then we have one house more. This is like old house. Nowadays it's more like summer cottage. When I say the best part, I didn't mean tractors. I mean that one. Our frozen lake. Oops, it's not frozen right now, but the lake is the best part. I have swum there so many times, maybe like millions times when I was kid. And the shore is not deep at all, so it was great place to play when we were kids. And then we have here sauna, and actually you have seen this sauna on my videos before, and this is really nice and cool old school sauna. And of course we have here hot tub,
That's also world famous.
Yeah, world famous hot tub. And pretty nice scenery. That is the place where I have grown up, and this is like paradise. And I understand it now, because when I was kid, this was really normal for me. I thought every family has place like this, but this is really awesome place. Yep, but hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching. Moi moi!